This is the third time we've run the Raspberry Pi Challenge at York. We're really pleased we got more students signed up this year than we've ever had before, and we've also mixed it up with some new challenges. The first challenge is a programming challenge, and we called it Pi Square. It basically involves programming your Raspberry Pi to act as a player in the old-fashioned game of squares.
Pi Square is a very nice competition, and that's something we've been doing for a few years now. It can help students to prepare for the new year, and especially to try Python even though they never programmed before.
We've got a knockout competition. We've randomly picked the students they're playing against each other all the way through to the grand final later this afternoon.
There's, you know, some very inventive and sort of imaginative ideas. The students definitely are coming here with more knowledge about computers, it seems. But that's what Raspberry Pi is all about, you know, create something yourself.
The second challenge is Blue Pi Thinking. I've been totally blown away by how creative the students are being this year.
Yeah, there's some really clever stuff going on now.
They're thinking about how you start to grasp real ranges of data that are around. That shows a real maturity that I just wasn't expecting here.
One extreme, we've got a guy over in the corner who's connected his Raspberry Pi to a toaster and is making toast over the web. And then one of my favorites, it's really retro, he's taken a cassette player. You put a cassette in, press play, it reads an RFID chip, looks up the MP3 and plays it. These are really amazing things. I can't believe that new undergraduates are able to do these sorts of challenging projects.
Making use of the Raspberry Pi in an environment like this is great fun.